Melissa, just between you and me, where is this weather picture taken? I won't tell anybody, I promise.
No. I can't tell you just yet. I will tell you the answer coming up here in just about 20 minutes. You just have to wait a little bit longer. Beautiful shots sent in by Lynn. I love this. Another one that I think you could easily frame and put on your wall as art. If you think you know where in the world this beautiful mountain and landscape is, head over to my Facebook page, put in your guesses, and I'll have the best guesses and answer coming up here in a little bit later in the show. You can also do that on Twitter. Email me at melissafry@kezi.com. High temperatures yesterday, it was a toasty one here across most of the state. We got back into the low 90s here in the Southern Valley, 93 for those of you in Roseburg, and 97 in Medford. That was one of the warmest spots here in the state. Central Oregon, upper 80s and low 90s for you. Same story as you head over to the eastern side of the state. And the coast continues to be that steadfast place that you can go to get some relief from the heat, where high temperatures continue to stay in the upper 50s and low 60s, and you stayed stocked in with the cloud cover for most of the day as well. Now, that high temperature that we saw of 92 degrees, that is 8 above average for this time of year. 84 is what we typically expect here in early August. That's the highest average that we ever do see, and that's going to drop by a whole degree after August 11th. So we are still in the hottest period of the year. The record for yesterday's date, that's 101, and that was set just last year. You may remember early August last year was a hot one. We still have yet to see any rainfall since late June. That deficit climbs with each day, now up to 15.77 inches below average for this point in 2013. Still the driest start to a year that we have ever recorded in Eugene, and those records go back to the late 1800s. Now this morning we're waking up to clear skies from Central Oregon all the way into the valley. Head out to the coast, though, that marine layer is quickly forming and quickly starting to move on to the east this morning. So we may see just a few brief clouds here along the I-5 corridor. Anything that we do see, though, it's going to be brief. It'll burn off with that sun up and going this morning. We're sitting at 55 degrees under clear skies in Eugene, 52 dew point this morning. Winds are calm, visibility at 10 miles, should be an easy commute into work. That jet stream, it has made a huge change from late last week. Late last week, it was down to the south of us. Now it's way up into northern Canada. So big ridge of high pressure on top of us, and that's part of the reason why it's so warm. This little area of low pressure moving through southern Canada is the reason for the extra onshore flow this morning, and why we'll see a few extra clouds and temperatures will just be about a degree or two cooler than yesterday. That will continue to hold through Tuesday, and then for the second half of the week, it's going to get interesting. This area of low pressure is going to start to move up from the south. It'll move across northern California Wednesday into the southern part of Oregon Wednesday night into Thursday. That's going to bring in some moisture. It's going to bring in the dynamics that we need to see some thunder showers firing up here across pretty much the entire state. Good chances in Central Oregon at the end of the week, and for Southern Oregon for those thunder showers, slight chances here in the valley. So we'll continue to monitor this with each day, but we'll see at least likely some clouds and some light rain from that. Otherwise, that marine layer pushes back to the coast this afternoon. We'll see that completely staying offshore on Tuesday, so more sunshine for all of us. And then Wednesday, again, that's the first sign of that low pressure area and the first sign of some clouds moving into the southern part of the state. So for the coast, low to mid 60s today. Sun breaks this afternoon. You'll see more sunshine as we head into Tuesday, up to 67 degrees, and then holding right there in the mid 60s all the way into this weekend. The Umpqua Basin, low 90s for you, sunny, hot conditions continue. 95 Tuesday, 88 by Wednesday. The Cascades, upper 70s, mostly sunny for you. Central Oregon, upper 80s and low 90s. Sunny, warm conditions continue. And then again Wednesday, that's when we'll start to see those thunder showers moving in. Best chances, though, won't be until Friday. And for the valley, low 90s for us, mostly sunny skies overhead. 93 on Tuesday, that'll be the hottest day this week. And then we settle there in the mid 80s for the second half of the week. Again, could see some clouds, some light rain, and a slight chance of some thunder and lightning.
So we're seeing the summer temps, but I want to point out, you know, summer is coming to a close. If you're busy tracking baseball,